Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to balance combustion reactions. First, a quick reminder, remember that combustion is a burning reaction where some molecule is going to react with oxygen gas to give you carbon dioxide and water. The molecule that combusts typically has a formula that looks like this. Some number of carbon, we'll call it X, some number of hydrogen, we'll call it Y, and potentially the presence of oxygen, which we'll call Z, reacts with O2 to give us CO2 plus H2O. To balance combustion reactions, I like to use the same approach that I teach in the last video, where you can find on my website, leiaforsci.com/reactions, by writing the atoms down the middle to show us what we have, in this case, CHNO, balancing the atoms individually, and then adding the coefficients back for the final number. What makes combustion a little different is that the oxygens tend not to add up, and many professors will teach you the confusing method of using a fraction. I prefer to do it differently. Let's start with the simple combustion of methane, or CH4, reacting with O2 to give us CO2 plus H2O. For the sake of simplicity, we're going to omit phases. We'll start with writing the atoms down the middle and seeing what we have on each side. In the reactants, we have 1 carbon, 4 hydrogen, and 2 oxygen. In the products, we have 1 carbon, 2 hydrogen, and 3 oxygen. This is because we have 2 oxygens and carbon dioxide and 1 oxygen in water. This is where the trouble comes from. Having oxygen in 2 different molecules, so don't miss it. Carbon already seems to be balanced. Hydrogen looks pretty simple. We have 4 and 2. Anytime you have half on one side, double the other, just double a smaller number. If we double the hydrogens by adding a 2 in front of H2O, that gives us 2H2O, or 2 times 2H for 4. It also changes the oxygen count to 2 plus the 2 that we have here for a total of 4. And this is pretty simple because the only thing left to balance is the reactant O2, which I always leave to the end in combustion. And again, we're dealing with a 2-4 situation. 2 is half of 4. Double it by placing a 2 in front. 2 times 2 is 4. Don't immediately jump on the answer. Check your checklist. We have 1 carbon, 4 hydrogen, and 4 oxygen on either side. If the checklist is balanced, you know the reaction is balanced. For a final equation of 1 CH4 reacting with 2 O2 to give us 1 CO2 plus 2 H2O. That was pretty simple. What if it gets more complicated? What if you're asked to balance the combustion of ethane? Ethane is C2H6. We'll react it with O2 to give us CO2 plus H2O. Start by writing down your checklist. We have C, H, and O. And let's see what we have. The reactants have 2 carbon, 6 hydrogen, 2 oxygen. The products have 1 carbon, 2 and 1, 3 oxygen, and 2 hydrogen. Where do we even begin? It doesn't really matter, but I like to leave oxygen for last because oxygen tends to be our troublemaker, so let's get everything else settled first. We have a half or double situation for carbon, so let's change the products from 1 CO2 to 2. This is going to give me 2 carbons, but also update the oxygen. 2 times 2 is 4, plus don't forget this one, 5 oxygen. We have 6 hydrogen in the reactants, 2 in the products. In this case, 2 is a third of 6, or 2 times 3 gives me 6. So let's add a 3 in front of the water. That gives me 3 times 2 for 6 hydrogen, but again, we change the oxygen. We have 3 times 1 in water, but 2 times 2 in carbon dioxide for a total of 7. And this is where we get stuck. How do we balance 2 oxygens and 7 oxygens if one is odd and the other is even? A lot of professors will teach you to deal with fractions here. On the MCAT, you want to avoid fractions at all costs. If you see a fraction and you can avoid it, run for your life. Fractions are confusing. Instead, here's what I recommend. Ignore oxygen for a second, but let's get rid of the odd number. If we double an odd number, we get an even number, so double the entire reaction except for oxygen. If you place a 2 in the front, make sure you remember to distribute. But that will give us 2 for the C2H6. Skip oxygen for now. We have a 2 here, so turn that into a 4. We have a 3 here, turn that into a 6. Update all of your atoms. In the reactants, we now have 2 times 2, or 4 carbons, 2 times 6, or 12 hydrogens, hold on to oxygen. In the products, we have 4 times 1, 4 carbons, 6 times 2, for 12 hydrogens, and now look what happened to oxygen. Leaving this for last, how many oxygens do we have in the product? We have 4 times 2 is 8 in the CO2, and 6 times 1 is 6 in water. 6 and 8 is 14, which is double the 7. That should be your clue. We doubled everything. And now all we have to do is figure out, how do I get 14 oxygens on the reactant side? If oxygen comes in the form of O2, there's 2 per molecule. 14 divided by 2 is 7. That means if I place a 7 here, 7 times 2 is 14, and everything should be balanced, but let's verify. We have 4 carbons, 12 hydrogen, 14 oxygen. It looks balanced. Let's verify our coefficients. We have 2 ethane plus 7 O2 to give us 4 CO2 plus 6 H2O. Don't confuse these numbers. That was me just showing you the oxygen count. If I was doing this as a practice problem, I wouldn't write these out, but I would definitely write these out. Let's try another one. Say you're told to balance the combustion reaction of propanol, which is given as CH3, CH2, CH2OH. We know for combustion, we have to react with O2 to give us a product of CO2 plus H2O. But we can't start balancing here, because if you look at propanol, it's way too messy, way too many atoms to account for. So let's consolidate. We have 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms, 3, 5, 7, 8 hydrogen atoms, and 1 oxygen. This makes it easier to see what we have, and it's going to make the count much easier. Let's start with our checklist, CHO, and see how many we have. On the reactants, we have 3 carbon, 1 and 2 for 3 oxygen, and 8 hydrogen. On the products, we have 1 carbon, 2 hydrogen, and 2 plus 1 for 3 oxygen. Oxygen, our problem child, already appears to be balanced, but let's not forget everything else. Starting with carbon, having a 3-to-1 ratio, that's very simple. Just add a 3 in front of the CO2, which gives us 3 carbons in the products, but it also changes the oxygen. And you want to be very careful. Oxygen shows up in everything, in the reactants and products, so make sure you always go back and recount. We have 3 times 2 for 6 oxygen, plus the 1 in water giving us 7. Oxygen is off balance, but let's hold off on it. We have 8 hydrogens in the reactants, so let's put a 4 in front of H2O to give us 4 times 2, which is 8 hydrogens in the products. Once again, we have to update oxygen. We have 3 times 2 is 6, plus 4, giving me 10. Now the carbons are balanced, hydrogens are balanced, but we're dealing with an odd-even situation. We have 3 oxygens in the reactants and 10 in the products. This is where some professors will show you a fraction, but we're not going to do that. Instead, we're going to double everything and distribute that too, knowing that the carbons and hydrogens are already good to go, so we can bring the numbers down. We have 1 propanol, so we double that to 2. We have 3 CO2, double to 6. We have 4 H2O, double to 8. Let's update all our numbers. In the reactants, we have 2 times 3, which is 6 carbons, which makes sense. Double of 3 is 6. In the products, we have 6 times 1, which is 6 carbons. In the reactants, we have 2 times 8, which is 16 hydrogens. In the products, we have 8 times 2, which is 16 hydrogens. And last but not least, we get to oxygen. Starting with a product, because the oxygen numbers are already predetermined based on the coefficient for carbon dioxide and water. We have 6 times 2, which is 12 oxygen and carbon dioxide, and 8 times 1, which is 8 oxygen and water, giving me a total of 20. That's expected because double of 10 is 20. The one that we don't know yet is O2. So how do we find that? We need a total of 20 oxygens in the reactants. Oxygen and propanol is fixed. If we have two propanol, each have one oxygen for a total of two. So we subtract 20 minus 2, giving me 18 oxygens to go. And the O2 molecule having two oxygens per molecule means we have to divide 18 by 2, giving us 9 O2. Let's count it up. If we have 9 times 2, that gives us 18, plus the 2 in propanol, giving me 18 plus 2 is 20. And look at that. Everything is balanced. We have 20 oxygen, 16 hydrogen, 6 carbons. For a final balance of 2 propanol reacting with 9 oxygen to give us 6 carbon dioxide and 8 water. That takes care of combustion, but what about something as crazy as this? When it comes to balancing acid-base or ionic equations, I have a shortcut that is going to save you a lot of time, and that's exactly what we'll cover in the next video. You can find that video along with this entire video series, practice quiz, and cheat sheet. First, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on any new MCAT videos. Then visit my website, layoverside.com/reactions, for the MCAT stoichiometry and reactions practice quiz and cheat sheet. The link again, layoverside.com/reactions.